Howdy everybody, Colorado Biker here, and I am about to go into the Ark Encounter. Yes, I'm in Williamstown, Kentucky, and I was doing my cross-country trip home from New Jersey back to Colorado in the new beautiful support vehicle, and I decided, well, it's not too far out of the way. I might as well stop along the way and go see the Ark Encounter because I'm curious about it. And strangely enough, it's raining. It's really raining, and we're under a severe weather alert. So is this a sign from above? I don't think so. So maybe it's going to rain for 40 days and 40 nights. Who knows? I might be in the right place. Oh, wait. The damn thing doesn't float. I might be screwed. And as you can see, I'm also wearing my beautiful infidel, those perceived not to believe, t-shirt. So I thought this would be a good shirt to go in there with, unless I get shot for being a Muslim. No, just kidding, I'm not. Anyway, so we're about to go in, and hopefully the rain will let up a little bit, and I'll be able to do a few pictures outside before I go into this. So anyway, enjoy the video, and we'll see what we have to come. Okay, well, here it is. And we're on the bus. Kind of feel like I'm at the airport. Okay, well, here it is. There it is, folks. One giant fake fucking boat. And look, we have a security camera. I didn't think Noah had a problem with security. I thought the rest of the world died. Anyway, they got bunches of big logs. Okay, there's the zip line. We're not gonna do that today. And as you can see, it's it's a shitty day out. It's actually really windy and nasty and pretty crappy. So we'll go inside and see what we can see. Okay. Oh, they got the dramatic music. The empty lines. It's like fucking Disneyland. What the hell? It's a theme park, I guess, so. See, do I have my wristband? Yeah, it's pink. I'm wondering about that. Okay, they have sound effects going. Thunder and lightning sound effects, and it's thundering and lightning outside. Can't tell which is the real thing. Okay. Delivery wagon. Okay. And of course the mobility scooters. I didn't know that they had those back then. Yep, more fake thunder effect. You know, you could turn the fake thunder sound effects off. It's probably gonna start doing that outside here in any minute. How are you doing?
Good. Would you like to get everybody's picture?
Oh no, I'm good, thank you. I brought my own camera, but thank you. What's the picture look like anyway? What is it when you get it? Okay, it's a green screen. That's that green screen out there. Oh, okay.
Yeah. And then there's another one that looks like you're inside the arc.
Oh, okay, cool. All right, well, thanks anyway.
Enjoy your day.
Thanks. Here's the other green screen. All right. Okay. The great deep shall birth forth. Shall burst forth. Ah, the firmament. Okay. We got lots of little cages here, I guess. Didn't know Noah had an elevator. Uh-huh. These are interesting. I guess that would be for water. Yeah. And this would probably be for food. Oh, and there's fake noises coming out of them. How interesting. So there's rows of them. Okay, more cages. You got this whole thing with cages. They're really into cages. Big ones, medium-sized ones, all sorts of weird-ass noises. Amphorae, the clay pots. Okay, more critters, more fake critters. Here's the little tiny ones. They're too cute, little tiny boxes. Okay, the lighting in here is atrocious. Of course, it probably would have been anyway. Aha! Noah. I'm not sure if that is sounds Hebrew, but it should be Aramaic, so they got that wrong. They got lots wrong already. Oop, they got flashes of light. Lots of lightning. Ooh, lots of lightning. Okay. More cages. More amphora. All right. Wow, this place is big on the inside. More jars. Okay. 99% of all species gone extinct. Okay. Noah did bring many animals that are now extinct. Let's see what we have here. Oh no, that's a cool looking watering system. I don't think they were that creative. There's an empty cage. Okay. Here we go. Okay, transitional species number one. I have a feeling we're going to see a lot of that. Thank you.
trilobite. What the hell? What's wrong with this? Coelacanth. That exists even today. And of course, a 200 plus million year old species. Okay. Well, here's a haul of the medium animals. Alright. Let's keep going. Here we go. And of course, dinosaurs. Here we go. Did you know up to 85 kinds of dinosaurs are on the ark, including two Tyrannosaurids, Stegosaurids, Ceratopsids, Brachiosaurusids. It's Brachiosaur. Okay. Didn't bring any of these. Smaller than bison. Okay. More amphora. There's an empty. They're probably still working on making all this stuff. Some big bags, who knows what's in those. Even more, they just lined the halls with fake amphora. It looks like they got here. How do we determine the number of animal kinds? This is interesting. Okay. I guess these would be brooding boxes, I guess, for some form of bird. Seven flying creatures and clean animal. Seven of each kind. Okay. Okay, now we have where we come to the fall of man, the pre-flood biblical stuff. We have day one, the Genesis account, all through there. We'll give them credit, the artwork is really good. They hired some very good artists. Look at that. Tells you all about the expulsion. Cain murders Abel.
They was bringing something to the world.
And then the fall of man, the descent into darkness, metalworking, music, polygamy, civilization, giants, and violence. Nothing new there. Artistic interpretation. That says a lot right there. That definitely says a lot as well. They do an artistic interpretation of everything. But it's good art. It's very good art. Hey, that looks a bit like the Maya or Aztec, Toltec, Olmec. Yeah. Maybe they're getting a little confused. Ooh, we're slaughtering dinosaurs now. Look at that. See? Triceratops. Or Stegosaurus. I'm not sure what it is. But, yeah, they're slaughtering dinosaurs. Okay? Let's see here. Living for pleasure. Hedonism. Yes, my favorite. I love it. Oh, yes. Look at this. Oh, they got some nice dioramas here, too. Look at this thing. Woo! Ooh, man, some of these chicks are hot. Okay. Oop, get a bit of side boob. Okay. Anyway, look at that. Pretty insane. And of course, a golden idol. A golden snake idol, no less. Look at that. Okay. And then the devastation of war. It's always been devastating. That's the whole fucking point. Divine judgment. This is where we come into. Yes. All right. And then there it is. There's the Ark and everybody clamoring to get on board and dying. And ooh, somebody being eaten by a shark. Look at that. Yep. Huh, that's a kid's level too, I wonder. Anyway, we continue. Now we're getting into the animals. Ooh, the big cages. Look at this. Now this is interesting. And of course, we're back to the kind bullshit. The Pachycetid. What? Pachycetus. They have Pachycetus, a transitional species. What's wrong with this picture? Okay. The Cynogathinid kind, another transitional species. Okay. Hyena kind. Yep. For some reason, though, in dog lineage, the golden jackal survived the flood without being on the Ark. There we go. The alligator kind. Okay, caiman, yes. Ooh, little ones, too. Little tiny ones. And they're eating grain for some reason. I don't know why. They're carnivores, but yet they're eating grain. And they got one massive water jug. So, yeah, this is weird. This is really, really weird. Okay, even more. And this place is huge. I mean, look at this shit. This kind of architecture? Yeah, Noah did this? I don't think so. And I see steel bolts and steel reinforcements everywhere. So, yeah, I think they're a little bit full of shit. So, it's pretty, though. I gotta give them credit. It is pretty. But it is completely fucking wrong. Okay. See? So, all transitional species. Every single one. Okay, here we go. This is how you indoctrinate young children. This is kids' spooky animal encounters. What do animals do when Noah's family is sleeping? They eat them. There we go. Open here. Can you make this face? Holy shit. Anyway, all sorts of cool stuff for kids. You got some creepy thing up here. Touch the skunk. And of course it makes you touch yourself. And see, it's dark and creepy. And so it's dark and creepy. This is a great thing to do for kids. Little passageway here. Kids only. We go through. Ooh, what do we have here? Something creepy. A couple of light bulbs. Ooh. Ooh, that's scary. Ooh, that's scary. Okay. Going along. Okay. We have yellow blob things. And things running around. Okay, what is this? I have no idea. You got a monkey? You know all kids love monkeys. It's a monkey, 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 monkey. Okay. So yes, let's indoctrinate the little kids. There's the movie. Alright, here we go. Rhinoceros kind. Trigonius. Another transitional species. Gee! Were unicorns on the Ark? Uh-huh. Yeah. Well, they did have rhinos. So, that was thought to be the rhinos. And look at this! This Pachycetid. It's not a rhino. Oh yeah, it is, but it's a transitional species. This is the precursor to the rhino. How could they do this? And the hippo and a couple other species too. Amazing. Okay, they actually believe this shit. More jars. And rows upon rows of cages. Look at all this. Lots of cages. Lots of Mesohippus. Another transitional species. Hmm. this is a bit crazy now. Every single thing that I see in here is a transitional species for evolution, not for creationism. They're actually making a case against themselves. Synthesirium. This is mind-boggling. People actually believe this shit. I mean, these are anti-evolution people, but yet they're using every species of transitional... it's just amazing. Okay, here we go. More dinosaurs. Ooh, look at a mean dinosaur. Got to get the kids in on this, you know. Look, he's sniffing his tail. You gonna get some, buddy? Yeah, she's hot. She's really hot. Look at those spikes on her back, man. Ooh, that is hot. Okay, I guess that's the punk in me. Yeah. Transitional species. Oh my god. Chiropsis. The hippo kind. Yeah, right. And why are they out of water? They're an they're a primarily aquatic species. Well, not aquatic, but you know what I mean. They spend most of their time in water. This is ridiculous. Okay. Stegosaur. Ooh, stegosaurs! I loved these when I was a kid. And once again, complete bullshit. Wow. Okay. Let's see. Kind of narrow that way. You'd think they would have packed the animals in here a little bit tighter than this. This is nice and open for a voyage for a year. So, Spinosaur, Baryonyx, look at that, Baryonyx, I don't believe it. Okay, wow, this is pretty incredible. So let's go over here, let's see what we have here. Okay, canids, of course. And look at that, there's the evolutionary tree, but they're creationists. Wait a minute. Phyllis. Look at that. Another evolutionary species. The only problem with that is it would be hyper-evolution. Evolution, if everybody got off the boat, and it was only, you know, 5,000-6,000 years ago, to get all the kinds we'd have, to get all the species that we'd have today, there would have to be something like 40 species emerging every day for 5,000 years. So, this is ridiculous. There we go. And they got another one. This is how they make it. They make foam for all these things. Look at this. Species give rise to new species. Modified characteristics develop over time. Yeah, so there would have to be something like 40 species a day just popping into existence, you know. Archaeopteryx. Uh-huh. See, look, they have question marks. They have question marks. At least they have feathers on it. So that's accurate. But we don't know what color. So... Archaeopteryx, yeah. Jurassic rock layers in Germany and mostly China. But anyway, okay, now we have us. Pongonids! Yes, the apes, of which we are one of them. We are a Pongone. Yep, we share a common ancestor. So, the Tyrannosaur. Yes. What did the Ark's carnivores eat? Okay. Preserved meat. Okay. So, yeah, there's our Tyrannosaurus. Uh-huh. Yeah, they had Tyrannosaurs on the... Okay. And they're eat, once again, look at this. They're eating grain. Okay. From everything we know about them... How the hell would they chew it? Their teeth are not designed for that. Their teeth are designed for meat, for ripping and tearing and slicing, not for grinding. They have completely the wrong type of teeth, so they would have to swallow it whole, which, well, you know, you're going to have a lot of farty dinosaurs in. Yeah, right. Okay, let's keep going. And let's see. Oh, is it? Yes, giant sloth. Yazadon. Look at that. Wow. They really are stretching it, man. This is really wow. Okay. Once again, transitional species. Stegokilurin. Fusarius. There's the Fusarius. Oh, and look, someone's gonna lose their fucking hand. She's trying to feed it. Yep, she's gonna lose her hand. And where did she get the fresh root vegetable from? That's a bit suspicious. Okay. Wow. Okay, animal care. This is where we get into the logistics. And this is my specialty. Logistics. Let's see, 850 per person per day. Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. Reptiles, amphibians. Okay. Yep. Picky eaters. Ooh, here we're getting into the logistics of feeding and watering. Large animals. Okay, that's interesting. Yep. Ah, and here's the system. Okay, they deliver drinking water, remove animal waste, sustain fresh air, provide sufficient light. Okay. So in here they explain all of it, and we'll show their little diagram or system here for dealing with all the waste. Now my question would be, with the waste, what about all the hydrogen sulfide, methane, carbon dioxide, and carbon monoxide gas that's generated by decomposing animal matter, as well as curing and decomposing wood from the actual boat itself? This would make it entirely impossible to breathe within this space if it truly had only one large window, as it says in the book. So it's completely, it doesn't make any sense whatsoever from a logistical standpoint. Ooh! Nigersaurus! That's a cool looking one too. They did a good job with that. They did a good job on the model. I'll give them credit there. They did a good job on the models. All right. Let's see, lighting. Ooh, hey, this is a specialty of mine. Lighting, artificial lighting. Let's see. Okay. Artificial lighting. Opening concept, covering concept. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, so this is how it's supposed to be done. Clean water. Okay, rain catchment. Cistern. So basic interlinked cistern system. Okay, so liquid waste removal. You gotta take a pee. Let's see, here we go. And it's some giant column thing here in the back. So, whoop. Okay, here comes some dude. Oh, the pee pipes. Ah. Okay, what about the urea? Yeah, there have to be the urea and the ammonia levels would be through the roof. Okay. Okay, that's one giant poop chute. Okay, let's see about the solid waste removal. Gotta do the poo. Alright, so wheelbarrow is full of poo. Go down. Oh, you're gonna be a shit shoveler. Wouldn't you like to have that job? And there's a... some elephant, pachyderm of some sort. And it pulls it up to the top and dumps it out. Why not just dump it over the side of the damn boat? Why did they have to get so complicated? You just dump it over the side of the boat. This is convoluted and very, very stupid. Okay. Ventilation. Now this would be the one. Wave-powered purifier. Okay, this I gotta see. Air come in, air go out. Ah, I see. They're using hydraulics with some form of venting system. Okay, just go back out. All right. Okay, wave-powered purifier. All right, this is incredibly stupid. Wow. I feel dumber for actually considered their concepts. This is, wow, I really don't get it. Alright, so, back to it. Okay, from here we continue. Let's see. We have Noah. We have the animatronic Noah answering questions. So we're going to go ask a question. So you got a touch screen. Ooh, they had touch screens on the Ark. Okay.
Yes. How many animals are on the Ark? That's a good question. There are about 1,400 kinds of animals on the Ark. And this works out to be fewer than 7,000 animals. I don't remember the exact number. I put my son Shem in charge of keeping track of those details. Any more questions? Well, back to my writing.
Good animatronics. Let's see what we have over here. Oh, we have the library, the record keeping. Look at this. What a load of shit. Okay, education. Could Noah read and write? Okay. Whole bunch of paper. Of course, you know, don't want it. Animal observations. And let's see. What personal items did he bring? Interesting. Okay, we're going to continue onward here. Oh, we have the wood shop. Yeah, the workshop for doing all the work on the boat. Try and keep it afloat for a friggin' year, which has never been done since and is almost technically impossible. So, here we go. Woodworking technology. Ooh, okay. Oh, and look, somebody's carving a little birdie. I don't think they would have time for doing artistic renditions of whatever in wood and whatever materials would be extremely valuable on the boat. So anyway, there's that. And this is what I don't get. You're on a giant piece of wood floating in the water, but yet you are going to have a forge, something hot enough to burn down the whole friggin' boat with metalworking. They got their metalworking blacksmith, the smithy, and yeah, okay. this really fucking is true. Okay, yeah, this is really stretching it. And they got a neat little exhibit here. Here we go. Who was Noah? And just kind of goes around, tells you, you know, who he was as a young man, and then getting his skills and being 800 years old and building a giant boat. His family, you know, all the good stuff. So, all right. And now we're going to go on to the second part of indoctrinating children, which is over here. Fairy tale arc. Let's go see the fairy tale arc. Look at this. Ooh, that's well done. It looks almost like Disney production or something. Look at that. Looks like Dumbo. That really does look like Dumbo, doesn't it? See? All right. So here we go in here. If I can convince you the flood was not real, then I can convince you that heaven and hell are not real. Oh, I like that. I gotta get a picture of that. And look. There's an evil lizard snake thing. I don't know. It's not really any kind of snake. Maybe a dragon? I don't know. No feet. But we'll see. So here we go. All the books. Ooh, all the old books of Noah's Ark. This is cute. The deceptions. 7 D's of deception. Disregarding God's word, distorting the message, deceptively cruel, discrediting the truth, destructive for all ages, disorienting the reader, defaming God's character. Okay, like a kid could read any of that. Let's see here. So these are all the books on Noah's Ark. Oh, and I got that cute Disney music. And everyone died except the 8 people on the Ark, or in the Ark. Yep, and that means that we're all a bunch of inbreds. Yep, that means we're all related. Everybody's your cousin. Yep. And, wow, we would have really had to been having sex like mad after this. So, anyway, look at that. This is crazy. This is crazy beyond crazy. Let's get the laughing kids in here. That's just, this is disturbing. Okay. Let's see. Help me understand. This is where they try to explain why the God of the Old Testament is such an asshole. Evil, vindictive, cruel, vicious asshole. Anyway. So, we're going to get a little animatronic thing here. Not just doing anything, just kind of looking, but good animatronics. Pretty damn lifelike. I will give him credit. Look at that. She even blinks her eyes. Wonder how much that set him back. And here it is. The door. The door. Hold on. Let's go to the other side. Get a better shot here. Okay. The door. I am the door. Whoever enters through me will be saved. Well, it's fucking closed. I wonder. I love their ventilation system. Noah was one hell of an architect, way ahead of his time. So let's see. One door to be saved. Yes, you must be saved from the watery judgment. Okay. Wow. So that apparently is the door. That is it. That's the door. Okay, that's the door. So, and there's a film coming. Genesis History is GenesisHistory.com. I would say absolutely not. It is not. It's a fairy tale. So here we go. All right, onward and upward to the next level. Oh, they got some goats. We're gonna go play with the goats. We're gonna go play with goats. All right. See, look, they got goats. For the kids. I think this is the entirety of their petting zoo. Goats! Yay! Right on. Look, it's the goats.
Hi. Who are you? Hello.
You're pygmies. Hello.
You like the fake one?
Oh, that's all right. I got a friend of mine. She's got a whole bunch of them. They know where their bread is buttered.
Yeah, we have animals up here every day.
Oh, do you?
And every day they change. Like, we'll have the goats up here today.
Okay.
Or we might have our miniature donkeys up here.
Oh, okay, good, right. Yep. Now, these are pygmy goats, right?
Pygmies. This one here is a La Mancha.
Oh, okay. I thought, yeah, you do look different, so. Yep. No, that's what my friend breeds is actually. She breeds pygmy goats. So
now this one here,
that and cashmere.
But he's part like a pygmy and a mancha.
He's a mix.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Well, cool. All right. Thank you much.
Very well.
So they got goats. They have animals up here all the time, every day. He says. So anyway. All right. See giant entrance hall. All right. We're gonna go up to the next level, deck 3 exhibits. Okay, there it is, Indoctrination Center. You walk along here. Blacksmith. And your carpenter. And of course they got stuff to where it looks like it's supposed to be storage everywhere. All right. But of course we know it's not. Here's another security camera. Didn't know they were gonna have that much problems. There wouldn't be a damn thing in here I'd want to steal. Ooh, why the Bible is true? Because the Bible says it's true. Yes, it's circular reasoning. Never mind about logic. Okay, coming soon. So it looks like they're still adding stuff. Why the Bible is true exhibit. Doors of the Bible. Ooh, it's like a graphic novel. Okay. What do we have here? The Bible is God's word. Fully inspired, authoritative, and without error. Unique and unified. Okay, 40 different writers, 1500 years, okay, faithfully passed down, no it hasn't, fulfilled prophecy, no it hasn't, what's the key to eternal life, that's a new one, okay, well we knew the bullshit was getting deep, but just didn't know how deep, wow, look at all the room in here, okay, the living quarters, what a luxury. Noah's family. Why are the living quarters so nice? Well, they're gonna spend a year there. And once again, it comes down to artistic license. Okay, so, into here, the living quarters. All right. Damn, that's nicer than my house. Shit. Shem Ariel. Rena, Chapeth. Oh, look, they got time to do pretty pottery. Yeah. Okay. Bunch of flutes. Cool flutes. I like those. Alright. Got all sorts of stuff here. Plants would die with no light. Let's see. Food that would rot in a year. Regardless, yeah, fresh fruits, vegetables, garlic, looks like little mini cabbages, onions, parsnips, I guess, or some species of carrot, herbs, and then, see, up the kitchen, all right, my favorite spot, giant amphora jars, so where they would cut all this up, got way, oh, look at all the fresh bread, yeah, right. Purple carrots, we've got some lettuce, grapes, there we go, some squash, now that would last long, artichokes would be gone really quick, onions, more white carrots or parsnips, and then basic implements and stuff like that. Some simple cooking pots and fire pots, which is what they did, and baking. Nice. I like how they have this. Okay, so this is an attempt to explain how they were able to grow plants with no light inside of a sloshing boat with not enough fresh water. They had plenty of manure, but no fresh water. So they would have plants, so they would grow food, I guess. This I find highly questionable. Okay. A loom for doing fabrics, but I really seriously doubt they would have time. Of course, then, you know, there's lots of fabrics, you know, lots of animals to get all the wool from. So, eating and meeting. Okay, looks like he has tamarind pods there, which you really wouldn't want to eat a lot of. Okay. Ham and Kezia. So they're going through the whole family. Alright. Oh, looks like this is where they have some of the birds in their living quarters. Never mind that they would stink like fuck. Oh, wow. Okay, raptor. Couple of raptors there. Okay. More birdies. Bird cages. And can we look up his tunic? No, we can't. Darn it. How about hers? I want to look up her tunic. She's cute. Okay, so more birds. More birds, more birds, more birds. There's an aquatic bird in a dry area. I think that one will be fine. Parrots! Yay! Okay, Noah and Esmera. Yep. So anyway, there's another one of their movies. Okay, most of the people are gone, so let's go into the Hall of Bullshit. The flood. What happened outside the Ark? Okay. Rocks and fossils, gradual burial. Okay, let's see what other forms of bullshit they have going. Ooh, the Ice Age. Let's see.
It's true that the area where the plains were discovered receives much more snow today.
Let's see, giants of the Ice Age.
But the conditions during the Ice Age that followed the flood would have led to heavier and more frequent snowfalls throughout Greenland. The amazing story of the Lost Squadron shows us that these are not annual rings. Once again, we see that observable, testable, and repeatable science contradicts the secular belief in millions of years and confirms the truth recorded in scripture.
Sorry.
My scientific colleagues go to places like Greenland, Arctic, go to Antarctica.
Fable. All right. Language. All right. Oop, got a cute little one. Oh, the Tower of Babel. Cool. Wow, that's a cool little diorama, too. All right. Let's see. God's Judgment, Table of Nations, Biblical Model of Language, Evolutionary Model of Language, which is more accurate. Let's see. People around the world. Towers from around the world. Superficial biological differences. Wait a minute. They're using genetics. Well, no, you're using chromosomal pairs. But still. Okay. And then towers from around the world. Yeah, we knew all about those. Babel. Aliens and the pyramids. Okay, this is ridiculous. Okay. And the Bible doesn't even mention the pyramids or Egypt or the Egyptian pyramids. They never mention them. So, ooh, used to promote racism. No, but it was used to promote slavery. Yes, you know, you can beat your slave as long as he doesn't die, you're okay. All right, let's continue on here and see what else we have. Ancient man. Ooh, let's see what they have to say. Brilliant or brute? I'm a brute. Oh, come on. I feel sad. They have Isaac Newton up here. In the one place that is the most unscientific. Although he was a theist. More of a deist, really. Of course, and everyone then was. Pre-flood potential. How could anyone build something so large and sophisticated? Well, we have castles. We have pyramids, so. But yet, anyone is still yet to build a boat as big as this one was supposed to be. And actually have it seaworthy. So, the Great Pyramid. Once again. Stonehenge, which is pagan. Celtic paganism. Time and navigation, which was actually pretty much invented by the astrolabe and other things. It was pretty much invented by the Persians. So, what else do we have here about ape ancestry? Oh, this is good. A flat earth. At least they deny a flat earth. We'll give them credit. Evolution of religion is true. Ape ancestry is true. Not ape. Well, common descent. We have a common ancestor. Technological explosion. From the horse and buggy to the moon in 70 years. All right, here we go. Sink or swim. Flooded with legends. Let's see. Flood legends. Yes. But only a few of them. And floods are common everywhere. Hey, they already have Gilgamesh. Look at this. They have Gilgamesh. And Akkadian. Right on. Altiak. Miatsu. Yep, but they all differ very, very greatly. See? Epic of Gilgamesh, but that's wrong. It's not cube-shaped. God bless them. More of this. Noahic Covenant. Okay, I don't know what this kind of stone tablet thingy is. Permission to eat meat. Capital punishment. So God's in favor of killing. Hey, there's no surprise there. Alright. No food, drink, or flash photography. Okay, Jerusalem. Hey, Voyage of the Book. Personal stories of taking a Bible around the world. Ooh, a Torah. Yeah, that's a Torah. A reading table, yes. Nice, that's a nice Torah, too. Okay, Ezra, Man Without a Home. So we're getting into the Jews.
Hey, it's the Jews, you know. Yeah, right. I paid too much damn money to come into the place. It's too damn expensive.
All right. So anyway, sending the Bible around the world. Just some basic stuff. Crude mock-ups. Ooh. All right. Palms Codex Leaf. Of course, these are all replicas. They wouldn't have anything actual real here. It would go against everything. Well, it'd be, it's not an actual museum, I guess you would say. It's just a house of propaganda. I do have a few items here, which could be. But I'm sure most of them are replicas. They're too valuable. Mexican monuments. Oh, 1811, 1641. Evangel Matthew. Great. So they have a few good examples of some of the earlier printings, other languages when they took it to Asia. Note, they haven't taken it to Persia or Syria or the Assyrian empires or anywhere like that because, well, they would have been beheaded because it would have been against Allah. Okay, more of the Torah. Ooh, an Esther scroll case. Cool. Reading. Shackleton Expedition. Okay. Africa. Or North America. Let me go through. John Eliot. One of the first Puritans. Let's come over. Geneva Bible, 1615. Bay Psalm Book. Other places. So that's it. They took it all over the world. Okay, less than 2% Christianity. Gee, I wonder why. So. Okay. And this is the Searching for the Truth exhibit. Looks like a Jack Chick track. It really does. Looks like a Chick track. Look at that. They're already starting. Yeah. Well, I might not get back here, but okay. This is the propaganda arm. So, I think that is it, because the top level is not open yet.
Okay. Well, we've had a walk around the Ark Encounter. So this has been an enlightening experience, to say the least. As you can see, I'm walking out now. So I would have to say that they've done a very professional job. It looks really good. The animatronics are amazing. The sound effects are everywhere. I think that's a big part of it, so it's not just some dry, plain museum. So it's pretty cool. So, however, it was $42 to get in, and then I had to pay $10 on top of parking. So for $52, no, I'd rather go get a cheap hooker. This is not a place I would like to, no, this is not good. So anyway, I mean, it's entertaining, and that's the way I look at it. It's entertainment today. So we're gonna see. However, there are some very troubling things that I noticed throughout the entire thing. It is just retarded on some levels. I mean, I can't understand how some people can actually believe some of this shit. And especially a lot of the propaganda type stuff that they put out there, calling it creation science. I think that's my biggest problem.
is that they're trying to conflate the two, you know, science and theology and religion, and it's not either. Yeah, this is basically just a small group's take on the history and genesis of our planet, mankind, civilization, and everything else. And it is so rife with errors and problems that I really don't see how anyone with any kind of reasonable education could believe this without having first been incredibly indoctrinated into this, you know, way of thought. It's actually kind of frightening. So, but we're getting close to it now, so we're getting down to the bottom. So I'm gonna have to exit through the gift shop, of course. We'll do a quick walkthrough on the gift shop. So just like any tourist attraction, you gotta walk through the gift shop. Exit through the gift shop, just like Hunter Thompson wrote. And there it is, exit through the gift shop. It's a rather large gift shop. Look at someone painting pottery, cool. Handmade fair trade. So there's the gift shop. Alright, what is fair trade? Line starts here. Great. Okay. Let's see. Ooh, we can get a coffee. Ooh, snack bar. Gotta have a snack bar. Ice cream too. Let's see here. Ooh, soap. Ooh, big gift shop. Love their reference section. Okay. Let's see. Yeah, t-shirts, all like that. Alright. Alright. Well, for spending $50, I can't afford shit in their gift shop anyway. Ooh, it's a steel ostrich. How amazing. Okay. More stuff. Okay, just like anywhere, exit through the gift shop. I got all sorts of crap in here. Look at this. Amazing. Cool. And they got some other stuff here. Yep. All sorts of stuffed animals and little critters and stuff. Okay. Got the ubiquitous snack bar for all your snacks. Pretzels, stuffed pretzels. All right. Oh, and the reference section. Yeah, I bet I could pull up a few things here that would... Yeah, well, let's see. Oh, we got all this stuff here. Ooh, they got, look, they got The Lie by Ken Ham, of course, and all of his books. The answer, the new answers, book one, book two, book three, book four. All his videos, stuff for the kids. Inside the Nye Ham debate. That was good. All right. Cubit. The ancient system of measuring. Fudge tables. Yep, lots of fudge. Lots of stuffed animals. And here we are, the Ark Encounter. Okay, t-shirts, lots of t-shirts. More stuff. All right, the Noah interview. And all this, okay. All right, and finally, I get to run away screaming. Oh God! It's frightening, absolutely terrifying. And it looks like they got their little zoo and all that that's going to be open. All right. Little other building here for who knows what. Well, that's the Ark encounter for me. That was interesting. That was also probably the biggest waste of $50 I've ever done. That was just retardation on a massive scale. I couldn't believe how stupid most of the stuff was. That was crazy. I mean, literally insanity. We'll get back to more of this now. So we got to take our bus all the way back to the parking lot. We're going to pay $10. So we're on our way back. Thank you all. You have a good day. All right. Well, and here's where you first come in. I didn't video it this earlier. But this is where you come in. This is where they're going to have the lines. And that's where you pay. So there it is. Oops. Excuse me. All right. All right. I'm done.
Howdy, everybody. Colorado Biker here. Well, that was interesting. Just got out of the Ark encounter a little while ago. Now I'm driving again. And that was a really interesting experience. My brain still hurts from it. I guess I shouldn't have been reading all of the stuff they had up there. It's just painful. I honestly feel dumber now that I have been there. It is really the epitome of stupidity. I couldn't believe it. For about, I'd say about a third of the time I was there for a good 4 hours. And I'd say for a good third of the time I was there, I was near this lady who kept saying, "Oh, praise Jesus, oh, hallelujah, it is so good, oh, God is good, oh, this is good." I couldn't believe it. Talk about brainwashed. Wow. A bit of a recap, it was $52 and change to go in. That included the $10 for parking, which I thought was ridiculous, considering that there are maybe 30 cars in the parking lot. Of course, then I went in, February. This is the first week of February, and there's hardly anybody there at all. It was great in one respect, is no crowds, didn't have to deal with a lot of people, anything like that. It was a bit nuts. Ooh, it's raining. I wonder if that's a sign from above. Yes, it's called water. Anyway, it was $50 to get in, and I had to take a stupid little bus. You know, felt like it was an airport. Well, basically it looked like a used airport shuttle bus. And went to the museum. It was raining outside, so I didn't get too many exterior pictures. Got a few after the rain lightened up, but I didn't want to stand out in the rain, get my camera wet and everything. So I went through the museum, and there's a lot of stuff in there that just did not make sense at all. Especially for an ocean-going vessel, you know, or I guess the whole planet would be flooded, but I guess that would make it one giant ocean, in their view. So it was crazy. It really was. A lot of the ways that they had explaining things, that this is how it could have been done, you know, we don't have anything other than it was this big. That's it. That's all they had to go on, was the dimensions, the crude dimensions of the boat itself, of the Ark itself. And a lot of the things that they were proposing would not work at all. It was ridiculous. They would not work for a boat on the ocean that's, going back and forth. Everything would spill everywhere. It would be a nightmare. Apparently, whoever designed this stuff had no idea of what they were doing. The boat would have been just a nasty place. And my question would have been the ventilation. What about the hydrogen sulfide gas, the methane, the carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide? That stuff concentrates. I mean, it built up pretty quick, especially in an enclosed surface. And not just from the animal, not just from the animals themselves. So you've got a boat made out of wood that was not properly cured because they didn't have kilns big enough to dry the wood, didn't even know about curing wood like that. So the wood would have been off-gassing. It would have been letting off probably carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, methane, maybe some hydrogen sulfide gas from when it started to rot, stuff like that. Because remember, this boat was supposed to be on there for about a year. So this kind of stuff just doesn't make sense. Now with wood and everything, you know, the urine, the feces from the animals would get, you know, packed into the crevices between the wood and everything, which might help keep it afloat, but it would also sit there and just fester and rot and decay. And I mean, the ammonia levels in the place must have been insane, possibly lethal, if there were that many animals as they proposed. It was just poorly thought out. I mean, the whole story is poorly thought out. So they did actually have a little passing mention to the Epic of Gilgamesh. So the Akkadian legend as well, which is very similar. But it's still, it's technically and logistically impossible from what they say, from what the whole place says. And it's not really a museum, it's a giant brainwashing factory. Everything that they have can be shown to be demonstrably untrue. It's fake. You can, with any basics of science, if you understand the basics of science at all, you'll soon come to understand that it's wrong. Everything that they have in there is pretty much wrong. It's amazing. There's a few true things here and there. I think they put those in just to, you know, give it some kind of legitimate support, because they need as much as they can get, because it was just ridiculous. My advice is, unless you have $50 to flush down the toilet, I would go somewhere else and do something else, because it is not worth it. It is really, truly ridiculous, unless you're going for a good laugh and you know that it's a bunch of bullshit. So, other than that, no, I would not go. I would go do something else. I'd go hire a cheap hooker for a half an hour for $50. I mean, hell, that'd be a lot more entertaining than this place. And especially some of the people I saw. I mean, there weren't many people there at all. I think probably maybe the whole place probably had 25, 30 people in it in the 4 hours that I was there. I kept seeing the same people the whole time. Maybe 40. But that's it. And I'm sure that's all they're going to get all day. You know, sure, it is the off-season, it is first week of February, but it's just not going to do well. My prediction is it's not going to last more than a few years before they go into bankruptcy, and all those tax breaks and everything that the county and state gave them are going to be all for naught, because it's going to close. Half of the place is still under construction. Like, not the Ark itself, everything in the Ark was pretty much done except for one exhibit, which looks like it's going to be something like a chick tract, the Jack Chick tract, which is, that's funny in and of itself. But it'll be interesting when they get that part open. I got a little bit of it. But other than that, no, don't do it. It's a waste of time, it's a waste of money. I really don't see it. Ken Ham has to be the most full of shit evangelical minister in the United States as of now. The guy's a moron. And he's fleecing good people out of their money just to attempt to brainwash them. I mean, it's a lot of it is also geared towards kids. You know, hook them while they're young. Get them indoctrinated. Get them into this shit, you know, before they can challenge it with any kind of intelligence. So, but that's my take on it. Enjoy the video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I know it's long,
but I had to show a lot because there is a lot. I gave you the best tour of the museum I possibly could in the short time that I had. I still had to get going. I had to get to Chicago tonight. So other than that, things are good. And remember, avoid that whole thing. Avoid the Ark Encounter. I could have gone to the Creation Museum, but I didn't want to give them any more of my money. So, and I pretty much know that's going to be a repeat of everything I saw at the Ark Encounter. So, that's about it. And until next time, remember, keep the rubber on the road, shiny side up, and keep on thinking. Bye.